Tommy Medler chasing down the 69 of Jesse Hickman coming out of turn number four. Fireball Roberts getting banged around. 69 of Hickman, left number one. Tonight's 20 lap feature in the mini stock will be that wily old veteran, one of the local favorites here. Previous champion Tommy Medler starting on the pole. Also a fine run, the 69 with the Eel handling race car, the 69 coming home second. That's Jesse Hickman. Up next, heat race number two in the mini stocker. Courtney 21, Jason Gregory. And on a mission is the J7 of John Byers. Already passed three cars, now he sets his sights on the lead. Here comes the J7 of John Byers, tracking down the 21 of Jason Gregory. Back straightaway is the J7 of John Byers. Right for the 171 of Kyle Courtney. Apparently having a little mechanical difficulty coming out of turn two. Bringing out a caution. Caution on the speedway. Flag for the J7 of John Byers.
Bobby Butler and him. That's the two they like the most.
Is in second place, followed by Jamie Witt, in the number one, in third.
Applause for third place finisher, driver number five, Gary Blanken. Gary, congratulations on a good finish.
Thank you. And we worked hard there. It's bad to get knocked out like that. I don't know, me and Kurt's big buddies, but I swear it's bad to have to try to pass a man and knock the crap out of him like that.
How was the track here tonight at Volunteer Speedway?
Well, it was good. I mean, it's a little rough hole over there in three. It's right where you want to go in the corner, so you need to go under it or above it. But, I mean, other than that, it's a pretty good track. It got a little slick, but you just got to get set up for it.
Had a good strong car tonight. Who would you like to thank?
I'll thank old Frankie Bolden and Chuck and Ron and Johnny. They all work on this thing pretty hard. And I go down there and piddle with them a little bit every now and then. Try to get to them a little bit.
You turn a wrench or two every now and then, huh?
Every now and then, they make me.
I wish you congratulations on that third place finish. Y'all give you a big round of applause. Gary Blanken. Coming out from under the hood there. Kurt Owens, congratulations, Kurt.
Yes, well, as you can see, it don't look good running up and under there, but that's the way it goes. We had a good race. We just had a little accident over there. I believe we had something for him anyway.
Who would you like to thank here tonight, Kurt, on this car?
Kip Roden. Guy helps me at Fireball. That's my crew chief. My brother Jimmy Owens too.
Fantastic. Good finish. Second place tonight. Y'all give a big round of applause. Kurt Owens. Winner. Good finish. Grabbing his number 36, Mr. Chris Rickett. Congratulations.
Thank you.
How was the track here tonight? You seem like you just had this thing from the get-go.
Well, it didn't feel like a get-go when I looked down under me and seen that car on the end there. I thought, I better go. But the racetrack was good. It was a little slick, which probably played into our advantage a little bit tonight because we don't got the motor that everybody thinks we got.
Well, this car seemed to hold real good on that high line. You seemed to kind of stay up in that upper groove all the way around the track.
Well, I didn't see nobody the whole race under me, so I just thought, it's working right there. I'm going to go. And after I seen Kurt nose under me a little bit on the last lap, I sort of pinched down a little bit, try to block.
Who would you like to thank here tonight, Chris?
Well, Joey, great old big guy over there, my wife, Bill, Alan, everybody for helping me. Without them guys, I couldn't race. And I've raced here, I've been here my whole life, helping Red Leffert, helping my dad, and it's the first time.
J7 of John Byers. He brings the 21 of Jason Gregory. We have the 007 spun over in turn two. Ran out of caution. Caution on the speedway. And it's going to be the J7 of John Byers, the 21 Jason Gregory. All the way to the first spot is Gator Chris Griffin. The speedway appears. The J7 of John Byers, 21. Chris Griffin. Sorted out. It's the J7 of John Byers with a 6-car length lead over the 21 of Jason Gregory. Back to the C8 of Chris Griffin as he gets a little sloppy in the corner turn two, allowing the 44 of Medler to now battle for that third spot. Still, your leader, the J7 of John Byers. Appear the 21 of Jason Gregory has now snuck up behind the J7 of John Byers. 9 on the board, 11 to go. Byers and Gregory in tow coming out of turn two. Coming out of turn one is the 007. Bringing out a caution. Caution on the speedway. Haston Collett. Gregory in the 21 getting a little loose, trying to take a peek underneath the J7 of Byers. He'll settle down now with a 3-car lead deficit behind the leader. And then it's the C8 of Chris Griffin, the 44 is Tommy Medler. Up to fifth spot, it's the 5 of Mike Townsend. The 21 of Gregory slings her high coming out of turn four. Doing all he can to try to get a little momentum to catch the J7 of Byers. combined battle now for fourth spot between the 5 of Towns and the 44 of Medler. Seven, J7 of John Byers, 21 Jason Gregory, C8 is Chris Griffin. Final battle for fourth with Tommy Medler in the 44 and the 5 of Mike Townsend. This time by, two left to go for your leader of John Byers. White flag for the J7 of Byers. Race fans, a popular driver here at 411 Motor Speedway, winning from the front row in the J7. Let's hear it for tonight's victor in the mini stock for John Byers.
Feet, let's stand up and wave to these drivers. They'll be waving at you. Wave your hats, your handkerchiefs, your jackets, whatever you can get a hold of, because they'll be waving back at you. Here they come as they round turn four, ladies and gentlemen. Let them see you. Let them hear you. Here they are, the cars and stars of the Chevrolet Performance Super Late Model Series. Wave at them. They're waving at you. Twenty-four of the top drivers in the country saluting you, the great race fans here at 411 Motor Speedway, thanking you for your support of 411 Motor Speedway and the Chevrolet Performance Super Late Model Series. Drivers have been shown the starting box in turn number four. They've been given their instructions, and now they're getting the one-to-go signal. If everything looks good, we'll go green next time around. 50 laps the distance, $3,000 going to the winner. Forrest Trent now in charge of the field from the pole position as they bunch up down the back straightaway. Forrest Trent, Mario Gresham to his right in the 21, lead him into turn three as they approach the starting box. They're in it, they're on it, green flags out, we're racing. Forrest Trent grabs the lead in turn number one. Gresham trying to get up ahead of steam on the outside in car number 21. Gresham on the high side, trying to get the momentum off of turn four. It'll be Mario Gresham leading lap number one with Forrest Trent in second. Jake Knowles third. Brandon Williams fourth. Anna Martin in fifth. Trouble in turn number four. Caution flag coming out. Trouble among the leaders in turn number four. The J1 involved. Josh Johnson. Looks like Tim Boucher involved in the 15. Field getting the one to go signal. If everything looks good, we'll go green next time around. Three laps in the books. Race leader Mario Gresham will lead him down the back straightaway. He can restart the race anywhere he wants to in turn number four. When he gets to turn four, wherever he decides to pick up the throttle, that's when the green flag will come out and restart the race. Field bunching up in turn number three. Gresham will bring him into the fourth turn, gets on the gas, green flags out, we're racing. And it'll be Jake Knowles driving underneath Gresham in turn two to take the lead. Jake Knowles out in front in car number 66. Trouble on the backstretch. It'll get the one to go signal this time by. We'll try it again next time around. Still three laps in the books. Jake Knowles was quick on that last restart, getting underneath Gresham to take the lead over in turn number two. Let's see if Knowles tries that move again or whether Gresham will try to go down to the bottom and block that move this time. We will soon find out. They're in turn four. Gresham's on the gas. Green flag's out. Here they come. Down into turn number one. It'll be Knowles down on the bottom. This time Gresham gets a run on him, as does Williams. Williams underneath for second. Williams trying to go to the point in turn four. But it'll be Gresham out dragging him down the front straightaway. Third, Adam Martin fourth, Forrest Trent in fifth. Adam Martin looking to the inside of Gresham. Got one slope on the high side of turn two. The 11 car, LeVon Sparks, brings out the caution flag. Getting the field lined up for the restart. Race leaders Brandon Williams in car number 95 took the lead on lap five. Second will be Jake Knowles in car number 66. Adam Martin running third in the 47A. Fourth will be Mario Gresham in the 21. Fifth will be Tim Boucher, car number 15. Forrest Trent running sixth in the 101. In seventh, it'll be Pierce McCarter in car number 71. Eighth will be the 47C of Tyler Crowder. holding down the eighth spot. Ninth will be Ryan King in car number 30, and 10th will be Ross Martin in the 47R. Here they come down for the restart. Here comes Adam Martin looking for room on the outside. Battles up front for the lead. It'll be Martin trying to pull up alongside Williams in turn number 4. Here they come off the fourth turn. Williams will lead by a car length. Caution flag coming out. So one down in the infield coming off of turn 2 brings out the caution flag. Looks like it'll be the 101 of Forrest Trent. So 9 laps in the books. Back out. Adam Martin all over the race leader, Brandon Williams. Jake Knowles right there in the 66. Top 3 cars up front battling for the lead. Here they come, wheel to wheel, off of turn 4. It'll be Adam Martin taking the lead. Adam Martin out in front. Brandon Williams back to second. Jake Knowles in third. Martin pulling away. Brandon Williams up on top of the cushion. He'll lose a couple of more spots as he begins to fade. Crowder up to 5th, Pierce McCarter 6th, Tim Boucher in 7th, Ronnie Johnson up to 8th in car number 5. Keep your eye on the Chattanooga Flash. Caution flag coming out on the speedway. Caution flag out. Car spinning on the front straightaway. Josh Johnson. Green next time around. They've waved off the double file restart. We'll go single file. Adam Martin out in front out of Talladega, Alabama. Second generation driver. His dad, Ross Martin, also in the race tonight. He'll bring him down for the green flag as he picks up the pace in turn four. Gresham looking to the inside and Knowles down the back straightaway as they battle side by side for second. Adam Martin out in front. Pierce McCarter trying to drive underneath Brandon Williams for fourth. Down the back straightaway into turn three. Ronnie Johnson right with him in car number five. Caution flag coming out. Got one stalled up on the high side of turn four. Headed down to the infield, it's Corey Hedgecock in the 23H. Six laps in the books, 24 to go. Adam Martin been running strong since he took the lead. He'll bring him into turn three as we get set for the restart. Pick up the pace anywhere he wants to in turn four. Green flag's out, we're racing. Jake Knowles looks to the inside, then it'll be Martin out dragging him by half a car length down the back straightaway into turn three. Martin trying to get it wound up on the outside. He'll pull Knowles a car length down the front straightaway. Knowles trying to come back on the bottom in one and two. Gresham still in third. It'll be Pierce McCarter up to fourth. And trouble on the front straightaway. Gresham gets out of shape, gathers it up. We remain green. Third, Ronnie Johnson will move up into the fourth spot. Fifth will be Brandon Williams in car number 95. Sixth will be Tyler Crowder in the 47C. Running seventh, Tim Boucher in car number 15. Eighth will be Ryan King in car number 30. Ninth will be Ross Martin in the 47R. And 10th will be Rusty Ballinger in car number 29. 28 laps in the books. 22 laps to go. So Ronnie Johnson still on the move. Started 23rd. He's up to fourth. Here they come off the fourth turn. Green flag's out. For second, down the back straightaway. Ronnie Johnson on the inside will take the position. Ronnie Johnson from fourth to second. Adam Martin out in front, but Ronnie Johnson trying to reel him in. Can Ronnie Johnson come from the back to the front? He's gaining on the race leader down the front straightaway into turn number one. Ronnie Johnson, the defending series champion, trying to send a message tonight that he wants to repeat as the champion of the Chevrolet Performance Super Late Model Series. He'll look to the outside. Here comes Johnson on the outside off of two. Down the back straightaway. Ronnie Johnson is there. He'll dive for the bottom in turn four. They're wheel to wheel down the front straightaway. Side by side into turn number one. Ronnie Johnson noses ahead, but here comes Martin with a head of steam. Down the back straightaway into turn three. Martin trying to get the momentum up, but Johnson up a turn four. Clears him. Johnson's your leader. Ronnie Johnson from the back to the front in 35 laps. Ladies and gentlemen, you have witnessed something special here tonight. Ronnie Johnson out in front. And he is pulling away as Mario Gresham's moved up into second. Adam Martin drops back to third. Pierce McCarter in fourth. Tyler Crowder up to fifth. Laps in the books, less than 10 to go. Mario Gresham trying to reel in Ronnie Johnson. Catching the Chattanooga Flash is one thing, passing him is another. 9 laps to go, lap traffic in front of the leaders. Gresham driving for everything he's worth as Johnson tries to figure out where he wants to go through this lap traffic. He better choose right, because now Gresham is right there. Mario Gresham closing in on Ronnie Johnson. We've got a battle for the lead in lap traffic in the closing laps. 43 laps in the book, 7 to go. Johnson down on the inside. He'll go underneath Jacob Grizzle off of 2 down the back straightaway. It'll be Gresham following suit on the bottom. Now the next car in front of Ronnie Johnson will be the 55 Orion King. 44 laps in the book, 6 to go. Johnson out in front, caution flag coming out. Got one stalled on the high side of turn 4. The 29, Rusty Ballinger, stalls in turn 4 to bring out the caution flag. He knows how to get to the winner's circle in Chevy Super Series competition. 2 career wins on his resume. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen, 1 to go. Field getting the 1 to go signal if everything looks good. 6 times around, 411 Motor Speedway to decide who's gonna get the $3,000 check. Can Ronnie Johnson seal the deal from 23rd to 1st? Mario Gresham looking for his first career win in second. Here they come. Green flags out. And Johnson will open up a 2-car length advantage over Mario Gresham. They'll come down to complete lap number 45. They're 5 laps, 5 to go. Johnson still keeping that 2-car length advantage over Mario Gresham, now opening it up to about 4 car lengths. 46 down, 4 to go. Ronnie Johnson hitting his marks in turn 3. Bouncing through the ruts down on the bottom, brings it off of 4. 47 complete, 3 to go. Ronnie Johnson easing his way around, trying to maintain that advantage over Mario Gresham. A little bit smoother through three and four. 48 complete, two laps to go. Two to go. Next time by, Ronnie Johnson will see the white flag. Here he comes. White flags in the air. He has checked out on Mario Gresham. Gresham beginning to fade in the 21. Johnson off the two, down the back straightaway. Ladies and gentlemen, he started 23rd tonight in the last row. Here he comes with the win. The Chattanooga Flash, Ronnie Johnson, is your winner. Mario Gresham second. It'll be Adam Martin in third. Fourth will go to Pierce McCarter. Tim Boucher fifth. Sixth will go to Tyler Crowder. Brandon Williams seventh. Eighth will be Ryan King. Ninth is Jaden Frame. And rounding out the top 10, it'll be Ryan King. We'll let him climb out of the Fast Five out of Chattanooga, Tennessee. From 23rd starting spot to the win, let him hear it, 411 Motor Speedway, Ronnie Johnson! Come on around here, RJ. We got to talk. I'm telling you, Ronnie, I have seen you run a lot of races in your career, and I was thinking this week that it's the, about the 8th year anniversary of you running from 19th to the win down in Loxley, Alabama, with the Neesmith Series. But tonight, I don't think I've seen this in a long time. Starting 23rd, coming home with a win. Did you have the confidence that you could get it done tonight?
Man, I'll tell you, you know, we're racing this series for the point championship, and we rolled that tire off in qualifying, and, you know, I'm just thinking, you know, just run 50 laps, stay, keep your nose clean, you know, get whatever finish you can, top 10, top 7, whatever. And, I mean, we got up to, like, 6th place. We had a caution. I'm like, man, I'm 6th. I mean, we still got half the race. I could win this, you know. So then I started going for it, and I'm just as surprised as anybody here. But, I mean, I thoroughly enjoy it. I love this place. It's been good to me. I love the fans. Fans turn out, you know, and support this thing, and, you know, it just makes the world go around.
They saw something special tonight, my friend.
I tell you, it, like I said, the last time I won here, you can't believe how much it means to me.
I tell you, you talk about, well, you know, you got to celebrate this win. It might be the last one, but boy, I'm telling you, if this would be the last one, it would be something that you remember, and everybody here will remember the rest of our lives.
Well, you know, the racetrack definitely had a lot of character to it, and the McCarters have done a great job. We're lucky just to be here racing with the weather that we've had. All the racetracks are, they're either underwater or if they get to run, they're rough. And, you know, I don't claim to be good on a rough racetrack. I'm physically not strong enough for it. But, man, it just made it where you could race tonight. You could just race, and if you were in a position to take advantage of other people's mistakes, and I was at times, and there was other times that, you know, guys broke, and I just missed running into them. And, you know, sometimes you get it, sometimes it gets you. So, but again, thanks to the McCarters, thanks to Neesmith Chevrolet and the Chevrolet Performance Racing Series, and the fans for coming out and supporting this great sport that we all have such a passion for.
Well, Ronnie, we thank you for putting on a great show tonight. Let him hear it, race fans. Ronnie Johnson, your winner. #21 out of Rome, Georgia. How about a nice round of applause for Rookie of the Year candidate, Mario Gresham. Mario, come on over here. Boy, I tell you, a great run tonight running for Rookie of the Year, and you sent a message that you're going to be one of the guys this year.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It was challenging. But getting out here, great series running with these guys that have more laps than I can imagine. It's fun, guys. That's it. A lot of people helping me get here.
Well, what was going through your mind when you looked to the side and you saw that number 5 go by after starting 23rd tonight?
Well, to be honest with you, I didn't see it till he was past me. It was a little quick there.
And then you chased him down in lap traffic, looked like you were going to challenge for the lead. What kind of things can you throw at a Hall of Famer?
On this track, not much. It was all I had in the last two laps. I was just holding on to the steering wheel.
Well, good job tonight. You held it on for a second place finish. Give him a nice round of applause, Mario Grescia. Coming to us tonight in third place from Talladega, Alabama, second-generation driver. Let's hear it for another young driver that led a lot of laps tonight, Adam Martin. Adam, a great run tonight. Boy, you really had the middle of the race. This car looked like it was unbeatable.
Yeah, it's good. It's a brand-new race car. It's the second time out in it, and it's I can't thank Barry Wright and my whole crew enough, man. It's unbelievable.
You're also running for the cruise with the Champions Rookie of the Year, and I think like Mario did, you sent a message that you're out for not only that, but this championship this year.
Yeah, me and my dad have worked hard over the offseason. He got me a new car, and I give him a really good car, and we're real geared up for this thing and hope it stays good to the end.
What happened at the end of the race? Looked like you were going good. Was it just the tires wear out, or was the guy driving that number five car?
Well, the guy driving the number five car and the right front give up, and I couldn't steer through the corners as good at the end of the race, but I'm still happy with third.
You know, when you looked at that lineup to start the race, you were starting up there close to the front. You looked back there in 23rd and saw Ronnie Johnson. Did you think he'd be there at the end?
No, and I mean, I never thought he'd be there, but you can't ever count him out. A little story about Ronnie. They Dirt on Dirt posted this past week that he won his first Southern All-Star race 1984 in March. That's 30 years in one day. I was born in April 84, and I'm thinking, God, he's old. And
he's still got it, though.
Oh, man, he's the best around this area. You know, I mean, I've been looking up to him since I was little. I got pictures of me and him when I was 5 years old. So, you know, I mean, it means a lot to run behind him.
Eat your Wheaties. You're going to have to battle with him all season.
Yeah, we look forward to it. But I really just want to thank my guys. You know, I mean, we've argued, we've cussed, we've laughed, we've hugged. They've stuck through us all winter, and we got this thing rolling. So I can't thank them enough.
Well, congratulations on a good finish tonight, third place effort. Adam Martin, ladies and gentlemen. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we want to thank all of you for coming out tonight. We hope you enjoyed the show. And ladies and gentlemen, you want to see us back again here at 411 Motor Speedway? Let the management know, because we love coming here to the Action Track of East Tennessee, 411 Motor Speedway, and we look forward to seeing you the next time we're here at 411 Motor Speedway with the Chevrolet Performance Super Late Model Series. Enjoy the rest of the program. On behalf of all of us, this is Roby Helm saying thank you, good night, and enjoy the rest of the program.